Hi, good morning and welcome back. Today we'll be talking about the black box in cars. The new generation cars are going to come with a black box system. So it's called the event data recorder, as same as in aeroplanes that we have the black box which stores the critical data in an aeroplane. And even after a crash, the black box will be in safe condition so that we can get the technical data from the black box and see was that a technical failure or any other technical aspect or any other thing which resulted in the crash or the accident of an aeroplane. The same such, we are going to have a system of black box in the automobiles. It is currently under construction and some of the modern vehicles have this system. The system actually mainly helps the insurance companies and the police department to get a knowledge that the accident was purposefully created, or was it really an accident, or the insurance company can make sure that the claim has to be honored or not by looking into the status of the accident. And the car manufacturers also will get an edge to see that the accident was caused due to a technical failure, which they need to fix it for more other vehicles so that those other vehicles in the field can be safe. So this is actually done. The data is actually stored in a EEPROM in the ECU. So the ECU is actually getting this signals. Those signals are like the brake, the speed of the vehicle, the speed of the engine, the throttle, etc. So I have given you two graphs, the case 1 and the case 2, which shows these parameters which has been captured by a vehicle which went into an accident with a black box system or the event data recorder system. So in the first case, the accident occurred, the data has been captured 4 seconds before the accident. So you can see the 4 seconds here and the data have been stored over here. You can see that the brake has been applied in this case. So in 0, you can see before 2 seconds the accident has occurred, a brake has been applied over here by the driver, and the speed has come down from here. From the second, you can see the speed has reduced, the vehicle speed, the engine speed has reduced, and he has also lowered the throttle. So that give you an idea that there was something unexpected to happen, and the driver saw that, and he has given away the throttle, the engine speed reduced, the vehicle speed reduced, he has applied the brake also 2 seconds before it. So it is not a purposefully made accident. And there are various other parameters also which need to be checked to make sure that was that a technical failure also. So this is a natural accident which happened. The driver was not doing it purposefully. But in this case, if you see, you can assume that in this, the 4 seconds before, it's shown there is no brake being applied. The graph is flat. The throttle was normally going high. The speed was normally going high. The vehicle speed was also high. So it shows that the accident has just occurred and the driver had no clue about the system. One, that he was not able to control the vehicle. The whole systems went wrong. That's not actually possible. Okay. And the second thing is that the driver must have slept. So he might not have seen what's going to happen, or he just went with the speed and he slept and the accident has just been occurred. So, or this might be a purposefully made accident. So if someone wants to purposefully make an accident, what happens is that he won't apply a brake, the throttle will not go down, it will be high, the engine speed will be high, the vehicle speed will be high, because he's going for a collision. So these factors can be looked into and make sure by the police department to make sure that was that a purposefully made accident, or should they have to, the insurance company has to acknowledge the insurance claim. So these type of systems will be going to come in the modern or new generation vehicles or cars. So that's the black box system. This is just the basics of it. And if you have any doubt about it, you can drop a comment. And also, if you like this video, please click the like button. And you can subscribe to our YouTube channel so that when we upload new technical videos, they'll be directly coming to your inbox. And thanks for watching this video. Have a great day.